All right, back for game three. This hand is pretty dang strong. We have a turn three win, I believe. It'll be very close to it, at least. So we're basically going to be in full-on race mode here. So if we draw like an Eker Wellspring or something, I think we would win on turn three. Eker Wellspring or Chromatic Star even. It doesn't look like he's going to win on turn three. So unless he has some way to interact with us. Again, we have to draw something though. It's not like we just have it. Echoing Truth is not bad. So I could just use that to buy some time here. That is not bad at all. If he goes for anything, I could just Echoing Truth. Otherwise, I'll do it at the end of his turn. So the biggest problem right now is I have no colored mana to be able to face reward the turn I play Karak Clan Ironworks. So I have to sack one of these Terrarians to filter mana. So it's a little bit less total mana in my mana pool. And I only get to draw two cards right now. So hopefully I chain a bunch of stuff. And or he lets me bounce this and I draw a Ghost Court or something like that. I cannot Echoing Truth a Ink Moth Nexus. I don't know why he's in the tank here. Drawing a Reshape would be pretty sick. I think Igor Wellspring's the best card to draw, still. More face rewards and Open the Vault are good. We're down to six of those, though. So we have to keep that in mind. I'm going to pause. I don't know what he's doing. All right, he's back. Okay, we need to watch out for Vines of the Vastwood. So we could have got him just there when he wasn't tapped. But like here, if he's just hitting for three. So this is six. I want to bounce it, but if he has vines, I would die. Right now, I don't die. So I'm just going to not die. I'm going to bounce this, though. In case I draw a Ghost Quarter and he doesn't have vines. I could have gotten greedy there, but it just didn't feel right. I mean, either way, it's a little greedy. This way I have to, like, win on my turn, but I think I have the ability to. That wasn't good. That was not a good draw step. Alright, well. We must go for it, so let's do so. Obviously, if he has any counter magic, I'm just dead. Alright, well, that worked somehow. Big draw! Ooh, that was really strong. Easily my best draw. Also very strong. Because now I get to sacrifice this for mana. Hopefully there's any graveyard removal. He does. I'm dead. Yeah, Gate. Alright, you got me. I couldn't really play around the gate. I could have bounced the guy that one turn. Maybe it was too conservative of me. I don't think we would have won anyway if we would have drawn these cards. How many draw steps do I have? I think four. Maybe I would have got there with the reshape. I'm not sure. I don't think so, though. But yeah, negate definitely got me here. Maybe I should have brought in silence just for that fact. I don't know. But I think this matchup is basically 50-50, and that's kind of how it felt. It's basically just a race. But I'll see if I can improve this going forward. I don't know how popular this matchup is, so as we explore the format a little bit more, I'll learn a bit more about my deck, and hopefully this matchup gets a little bit better. Woo!